I normally be fishing with a lead attached to a swivel attached to a curly tail. You don't have to cast it out that far because the fishes are just sitting inside of the impact zone. The impact zone is where the waves break. The lead would drag across the sand, and then that would attract the fish to whack the curly tail. I was lucky on my second cast. I caught this puppy. Sometimes you have to work it back and forth to get it out. I'm just gonna release it by pushing it back and forth.
Was a great catch and release. Next, Jaiden shows you a basic whipping or fishing setup that you can use as a floater or a lead.
I'll be showing you how to make a curly tail setup. Right now I'm going to be using a medium action rod with a 6-pound test. So first thing you want to do is put it through this floater. Usually we fill up the floater like halfway, but when it's more windy, then you fill it up more. Once when you put it through the floater, then you use a swivel, just tie a knot. After you tie on the swivel to the main line, then you tie on the other line that attaches to the swivel. After that, then you tie the hook. We'll be right back. Okay, now you cut off the line that you don't need. These hooks are the wide gap boat hooks. You use these for the curly tails. And now I'm gonna hook the curly tail onto the hook. So we got a floater coming down to a swivel and then coming down to our